What's up, y'all? My name is Gabby. I'm 12 years old and I'm pregnant as fuck. I'm not. Don't you worry about that. Not bringing a child into this world. Not in this economy. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new. My name's Danny Waygood. Today I'm going to take you through all of my tattoos. I've not done a sit-down video on this channel for a little while, so I thought it was time to sit down and talk about me, my favorite subject. So I'm just going to give you a run through of all my tattoos. I currently have 10 tattoos, technically 9, but one is like one with one over the top of it. So it was 2 separate tattoos. I paid 2 separate tattoo things. They're 2 tattoos. So I'm going to start with the first 2 tattoos that I got at the same time, which was part of my 18th birthday present to myself. So the first one I got was on this index finger, which is a semicolon. And then on my right ankle, I have a tattoo of my 2 kittens. Well, they're not kittens anymore, but they're kittens in my heart. My 2 cats, Coda and Mr. Whiskers, looking through a wine glass. I found there was an inspiration picture on, it must have been Pinterest, and I sent the artist the photos of my 2 cats, and she redrew it as them 2 looking through, because you'll notice that there is a very distinct theme here. I have a lot of cats tattooed on me. I don't really know kind of how it happened. It just sort of did. So moving on. Now, I don't know if this is any accurate order or anything, because I don't actually remember what order I kind of got them in. I'm gonna do my best as well to put the @s of the tattoo artists that did them. For my first 2 tattoos though, I cannot for the life of me remember where I got it done. Well, I know where, but I don't know the name of the tattoo artist at all. It was at one of them tattoo places in the shopping centers that are so extortionate. Don't go there. Go to an actual tattoo parlor. I'm begging you. But we have on my right shoulder, I have, it's a 5 of diamonds, but someone's redrawn a deck of cards as cats. So that is 2 cats hanging out the washing, and it's the 5 of diamonds. And then on my left outer thigh, I have the 2 of spades, and that is 2 cats playing ping pong. I also actually found them off of Pinterest, but it's kind of they combine my love of cats for also growing up with my extended family. The one time you'd kind of get everyone at the table is when we're all playing a game of cards. So that's kind of what drew me to them. Got a 777 on the back of my left arm as well. This was for a girl that I worked with her at the time when she was just first starting out as a tattoo apprentice. And she literally just put on her Instagram story, tattooing angel numbers for practice. It was completely free. I just kind of gave her the font that I wanted, but the font that I liked, it had such a weird 7. She redrew the 7 the exact way that I wanted. From the same girl, I've got a candlestick up the right side of my ribs, I guess. It's just kind of straight down the side of me. That one, don't really have a meaning for it. I just kind of had a tattoo appointment and that is what I found. It was good. I like it. I really like it. A lot of people think it's a Harry Potter wand though, and it is not. I promise you, it is not a Harry Potter wand. But it does, because it kind of finishes, the flame is sort of under my bra line, you do kind of only see, you only really see the base and the actual candle. So it understandably kind of looks like a wand. But I do not have a Harry Potter tattoo, I promise. Next, I have on my, below my left knee, on the, if you're looking at it, it's on the left-hand side. We started off with just a 305 for Pitbull, famously one of my favorite rappers. This is honestly I get a bit weird telling people this story because I don't know why I have a Pitbull tattoo, you know? I couldn't tell you. But I do. So I've got a 305, and then later on I went around and had like a kind of outline of the world. It's inaccurate though, so don't come for me about that. I had like the world kind of put around it. The tattoo artist though, she didn't really have the vision that I quite had because it was off center. And she said, she was like, if it was in the middle of your knee, I'd be able to do it no problem. And I was like, that would look ugly. But anyway, not important. So I do need to get that touched up just with like the dots that are around the outside. And then on my left arm, my left bicep, I have a fairy. Now this fairy is a, it's kind of hard to explain it. It's a seed pod fairy. I gave the tattoo artist, she did really, really well. I'm so happy with how she kind of did this. So I found like the Fantasia Disney sketches for like the seed pod fairy kind of models, and I showed her what like poses and parts and like skirts that I liked from all of them, and she essentially just mashed them all together to kind of make one that was specifically mine and wasn't like exactly what was on the thing. And that was really nice. I really, really like this one. Now for quite possibly my favorite tattoo. This tattoo is on like the left-hand side wrapping around my ribs. This I got in Italy when this was my first like holiday by myself. I was bricking it. I was looking for a shop to buy a charger and I found a tattoo parlor. So I went in and I looked through all of their flash sheets and I came across this and I went up to the artist. I was like, are you able to do this today? And she was like, yeah. And then was like, oh, and then do you want this filled in or not? Like, and I was like, no, exactly as it is. She just looked so happy that I just wanted it exactly as it was on the flash sheet. And I am so happy with it. It's huge. And it's 5 dancing kitties all wrapped around my ribs. It's my favorite tattoo by far. I just love it. I think it's got so much personality, and it also reminds me of when I was on my first big girl holiday. I was so scared. I didn't really go out past like 8 p.m. a single night that I was alone in Milan, but I'll always remember that's when I got this tattoo. So yeah, that is my tattoo tour. That's me, guys. Just so you know, in case you were wondering, I'm sure the collection will grow over the years, but this is me as of right now. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you like my tattoos. And if you don't, that's okay. I will see you next Monday.